So the first piece in the program is by Robert Schumann. It was composed in 1849. Fantasy pieces, three pieces, originally for clarinet and piano, and there's also a version for cello. And the three movements are interlinked by the key. They're all in the key of A, A minor, A major. And the first movement is very tender, second movement is lively, the third is fast and fiery. This is Schumann fantasy pieces. Three separate movements, but they move quite quickly to the next one.
Thank you.
scheduled to compose a Cello Sonata. And as he always did, he composed a slow movement first. And the Elégie was that slow movement, and he never completed the sonata, so it's only the one movement. It's one of his most famous pieces, and it's an outpouring of sadness and sorrow. This is in the minor. There's a small section in the middle that it becomes a little bit more, I guess, uplifted, but it just returns to that very sad.
Thank you.
sonatas. And I was quite inspired by his piano concerto. It's in the same key, and it's equally as exciting for both instruments. It's written in three movements. And the first movement is very agitated. It's very storm-like. And if you imagine the big storm in the ocean, and then you have this moment where the sun comes through and calms down, you have that happen here twice. It's this sort of slow section. And the melody in the first one, the slow sections, always starts with three repeated notes. And that actually becomes a theme throughout the piece. The second movement is equally as beautiful. It starts with that same three-note pattern, but in a different version. And the second movement is very much, it's a lot of soft chords, beautiful melodies, very much hymn-like. And it's very sort of Norwegian. If you think about the music of Grieg, if you hear it, you immediately find some kind of connection to Norway. And then the third movement starts with a cello solo, and then it leads into this very exciting folk-like theme. And as in the first movement, you have fast sections, slow sections, fast and slow, and the slow part in the last movement is exactly the same theme. The fast section just slow down, but it doesn't, you didn't know it probably necessarily what it has. It's a very different character. And then the movement ends very exciting.
Thank you.